Walking every day, walking all the way, walking with Jesus, walking with Jesus.
Hello children, my name is Auntie Issy. Yes, and it's such a pleasure and a delight to be with you here today, right? Okay, can you see all these books? Can you see them? These are my daddy's books. Yes, I'm visiting my daddy and my mommy. I remember some of the things my daddy and my mommy taught me when I was little. They have shaped me and made me who I am today. Okay? I remember one of the things my daddy used to tell me when I used to be a fighter when I was young. And my daddy would tell me, hey, don't do that. A woman is an embodiment of poise and beauty. You shouldn't be fighting. Okay? And I'll be like, you know, but it changed my life. All those things that my daddy and my mommy took time to teach me. And so, we're going to be talking today about that sort of thing. I remember last week, Auntie Uju told you guys about good and bad advice. Today, we're going to be talking about hanging with the wise. You see, in last week's story, Auntie Uju told you about how King Jeroboam chose the counsel, chose the advice of his friends. And that was bad. You see how that ended up? You should always be around wise people. Okay? So we'll talk more about it as we go along. But for now, let us pray. So close your eyes. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for this wonderful day that you have made. Thank you for bringing us into this time. Lord, we ask that you teach us what you want us to know in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for keeping us alive. Thank you, Mighty King of Glory, for always teaching us good things, stories from the Bible that help us live our life here on earth. Lord, we give you all the glory and all the praise in Jesus' name. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen.
Gorgi, remember to finish your tiffin and be home on time. I know how much you love playing and splashing about in water. Son, and please stay away from the river. That's right behind your school. You will remember, right?
Mama, who would dare to cross a mighty elephant like me? My name is Gorgi.
You should never forget, son. There are many more animals in our jungle that are stronger than you. Got it?
Okay, Papa. I will remember that. Bye, Mama. Bye, Papa. Let's go, friends. Let's go and play in the river.
Not today, Gorgi. I'm going home.
Me too.
Come on, DJ. Let's go. These guys are too scared.
But I won't play in the river. I'm scared of going into the river.
Gorgi, and he's all alone? It's time for some fun. I am Maggie.
Maggie.
Gorgi!
Maggie.
Come on, boys.
Gorgi!
DJ, help me! DJ, don't leave me! Come back! Mommy, Papa!
You got lucky today, Gorgi. But I'll come back for you.
Sorry, Papa. I will never disobey you in future. I will always listen to Mama and you.
That's okay, Gorgi. Next time, be more careful.
Let's say thank you to Auntie Uju for that beautiful video. Okay, it was a nice one. But oh my God, that Georgie was foolish. Chai! And his mother had given him a wise instruction for him to just obey. And he refused. Hey, he went to the river after school. And his mom told him not to. But thank God, his wise friend didn't go into the river with him. Ha! That crocodile would have had Georgie for lunch, I tell you. And he would have just lost his life like that. You know, sometimes our life is like that. That's why we need wise people. Wise people that will pull us back when we are making a mistake, you know? Like your parents, like George's mother, like my daddy and my mommy, my dad who used to tell me not to fight when I used to like to fight as a child, you know? Like your teachers, your mentors, like your swimming coach, your music coach, all these people, all your teachers in church, you know? All these people, God put them in your life for a reason. There's a reason why every one of these people are in your life. You should listen to them, obey them. Listen, if you don't obey someone in your life who is supposed to be taking care of you, someone who is supposed to be teaching you wise things, you think that person will keep teaching you? No. Our Bible verse for today, like you can see over there, it says, taken from Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20, that if you want to be wise, you
should walk with the wise. Let's read it together. Walk with the wise and become wise. Can we take it again? Walk with the wise and become wise. Georgie almost lost his life. If you walk with the wise, you won't find yourself in compromising situations like that. Just do what the Bible verse says. God has put so many instructions for us in the Bible. For us, because He loves us, let us listen to the Word of God. Yes, still here in Daddy's house, in Mommy's house. I'm gonna be here all day. Okay. Right. Okay. It's time for our Bible story, and it's about four wise characters. The first one is Lois, then Eunice, then Timothy, and Paul, Apostle Paul. You know Apostle Paul, the one that was busy persecuting Christians, killing them until Jesus Christ arrested him and started using him for the kingdom of God. Remember that story? Okay, but today we're going to begin with Lois, a grandmother, a woman. She had had her own child, her daughter's name, Eunice. And she brought Eunice up in the way of God and taught Eunice wise things. And when Eunice had her own child, she had a baby boy. Eunice, of course, now she was brought up in the way of the Lord and she was a wise person. What do you think will happen? Her son got all of that. She taught him about Jesus, taught him the way of the Lord, and taught him wise things. And so Timothy grew up in the way of the Lord, and he was wise, and he did work in the church. He worked for God really hard. So hard that the people in the community, they appreciated him. And when Paul, who was always going around preaching to people, traveled to that their town of Lystra, he met Timothy. Yeah? And the people there, they even told Paul that, this boy is so hardworking for God, you know. And Paul himself saw it. So Paul thought to himself, why don't I ask Timothy to come along with me on this my missionary journey? And of course, he did, and Timothy agreed, and he went on with another very wise person. How many of you know that Apostle Paul was so wise? So, when you hang out with wise people, what happens? You guessed it. Like your Bible verse said, to become wise, you walk with the wise. So, he was moving around with Apostle Paul and learning things, more things about God and how to grow a church and how to work harder for God and all of that. But you know, in those days, Christians used to receive a lot of persecution. So Paul was arrested. But you know what? When Paul was arrested, even while in prison, he was still thinking about Timothy. Why do you think he was thinking about Timothy? It was because Timothy was a good student. He paid attention and he did as he was told, and he learned, you know. He didn't disobey, because if you have someone that is a mentor or your parent, they don't like it when you disobey and don't be happy with you. But Paul was thinking about Timothy still like his own child. That was how he took him anyway. So he wrote to Timothy and he reminded Timothy that, look, you're alone out there. I want you to remember all the things that your mommy and your grandmother have taught you. I want you to remember that God has put talents and gifts inside of you. I want you to remember that you should not be ashamed of the kingdom of God. Don't be ashamed of God, oh. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. You know, sometimes some children are ashamed. You know, when they're in church, maybe dancing, or they say, come, let's go and minister to some people. Let's go and share tracts for some people. They'll be like, I don't want my friend to see me. They will laugh at me. You know, Jesus isn't somebody you should be ashamed of at all. You should do the work of God with all zeal and all power. That is wisdom. That's wisdom. And that was what Paul was teaching Timothy. Teaching him wisdom. He also told Timothy that Timothy should read the Bible. He said that, see, Timothy, the scriptures, that is the Bible. You know, scripture is another word for Bible. He said the Bible is from the inspiration of God, meaning that Timothy should read the Bible and learn things about God from the Bible. And what do you think Timothy did? Of course, now he will listen to someone who is his mentor, someone who is wise and taking care of him. And that was the life of Timothy. Now, guess what happened to Timothy? Did he almost get eaten up by crocodiles? No. But Timothy was very successful in the work of God that he was doing. He even became a bishop. Amazing! Yes, that is what happens when you work with wise people. So, do we want to be wise? Then work with wise. Just like your Bible verse says, Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20. Work with the wise and become wise. So Timothy had Lois, his grandmother, he had Eunice, and he had Paul. What a wonderful thing to happen to someone. When you have these kind of people in your life, don't take them for granted. Don't do like George, who didn't obey his mom and got so frightened when the crocodile almost ate him up for lunch. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for all that you've taught us in this Bible lesson today. Help us to follow with all diligence, with all zeal, with all love and with all respect, everything that our daddy and our mommy teaches us that is so wise. Father, thank you for putting wise people in our lives. Help us always follow them in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Our God is so good. He's so mighty. He's so great. Always appreciate your Maker.
Because the Bible tells me to. I obey because I love God. I obey because I love my